Good morning, everyone, and welcome to today's service. Today, we are going to chant Hanju-san, and Hanju-san is not in the service, Hashin Buddhist service book, so please keep watching the screen for Hanju-san. And we are going to read Jodo Shinshu Creed afterwards, but you will see Jodo Shinshu Creed on the screen too. So please join me in Gassho, please put your palms together. Namo Amida Butsu, Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu. Namo Shishin Kimyo Urai.最方阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏那釈迦如来心吽度諸上諸言無諸是異度者罰憤懸疑右阿蘇上仏道修行惑節人伝異情報惑節菩薩涅槃人惑前惑頓明空人無義小賢僧上根性理社会無薬頓言無知難解語南無阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏南有楽境地右折禅悟右満語宿生不退勘行弥陀仏透析即是頓解右菩提像一日七七日千生仏明談修有諸安楽一日に生みだ涅槃獄即得大正無上満語宿実難俗一時煩悩百千言 Nyaku dai sha ba shou bo u nin roku do u go u ja ko mi go namo amida mu namo amida mu na Isai
大如来説法弁躍動今日釈迦尊随喜説法皆無躍獲得五戒義右心門門門不動八萬士異滅無明加護院利権即是弥陀護佛一生少年在海上南無阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏瑞利吉伽吉伽コウシュシャバ自頭以来情報楽現見如来に文母心情十分起源非加護今日四方国実是舍婆本師利吉若彼本師知識観弥陀浄土運河に徳勝浄土法師音南無阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏南無阿弥陀仏阿弥陀佛，南无阿弥陀佛，南无阿弥陀佛，南无阿弥陀佛。南無阿弥陀佛南無阿弥陀佛南無阿甘尼悉苦陀
ナマンダブツ Now, I would like to read Jodo Shinshu Creed, which will appear on the screen. But also, if you have a physical copy of Shin Buddhist Service Book, Jodo Shinshu Creed will, Jodo Shinshu Creed is on page 12 of Shin Buddhist Service Book. Jodo Shinshu Creed 1. Entrusting the vow of the Buddha and reciting the sacred name, I shall proceed through the journey of life with strength and joy, revealing the light of the Buddha. Reflecting upon my imperfect self, I shall strive to live a life of gratitude, following the teachings of the Buddha, discerning the right path. I shall spread the true Dharma, rejoicing in the compassion of the Buddha, respecting and aiding one another. I shall do my best to work towards the welfare of society. Namo Amida Butsu, Namo Amida Butsu, Namo Amida Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda. So good morning again, everyone, and welcome to today's service. And usually, third Sunday of December is Mochitsuki, so we don't have service on this Sunday. But because we were not able to hold Mochitsuki at the temple this year, we have service today. So another chance to listen to the Dharma for everyone, and another headache for the minister thinking about what to talk. So please allow me to give just a Dharma chat, not the official Dharma talk today. But this is the holiday season, and people think of Christmas when we say the holiday in December. But we Buddhists have Bodhi Day, that is December 8th. If we count December 8th Bodhi Day as the first day, the 18th day from Bodhi Day is December 25th. Why 18? Because the number 18 is one of the most important numbers for Jodo Shinshu Buddhist. Because the primal vow, or Hongan, is the 18th vow of Amida Buddha. So December 25th could be important day for Jodo Shinshu Buddhist too. But well, it does not mean that Buddhists should not celebrate Christmas. I am happy for the Christian people for welcoming one of the most important celebrations of the year for them. And I just don't celebrate Christmas as Christian people do. But because of this Christian tradition, December 25th is holiday, and we have chance to get together as family, so I appreciate this opportunity. You know, this year is in unique situation, but I still hope that most of the family are able to get together even virtually. Just like the Dharma families are getting together or gathering online right now. It is amazing how technology improved over the years. Since this pandemic began, my children are calling to their uncle, my wife's brother, to play a Nintendo Switch game, Animal Crossing. Do you know the game? You know, so they play Animal Crossing together a few times a week. So they cannot see each other physically, but they are able to play online together. And maybe in the future, the display will not be the boxed shape like now, but it will be more like a holographical or holography. And we feel like the person is actually here with us. But anyway, since this is one of the family time of the year, I thought about my family. December is also the Shotsuki monthly memorial month for my mother, and I think about her often around this time of the year. My sisters are doing well. My father just turned 72 years old. And he regularly participates the study session online with the other ministers, so I see him often online too. I have shared that I am the 15th generation of the minister's family many times in my talk. And as you see the pictures of my home temple, a picture of me after a few months of receiving Tokudo ordination in 1996, you know, I was really thin back then. But this year, my home temple welcomed 382 years, and I am glad to be the part of the history of the temple. Considering how younger people are able to choose their own jobs now, it is amazing how many generations of my ancestors became ministers and took care and handed down the temple and the teaching of Nembutsu Dan to me. So even though I am not going to take over my home temple, I strongly feel that I have to share the teaching of Nembutsu as much as I can, because I believe this is the wish of my ancestors I succeeded or I received from my ancestors. So today's talk's theme is succession. You know, a few days ago, my daughter asked me an interesting question. What Santa Claus looked like when he was a baby? So I just told her, well, he had beard since he was a baby. But with the second thought, I told her again that, well, Santa Claus was an ordinary baby back then. And when Santa Claus dies, one of the elves becomes Santa Claus. Do you know concrete answer for this? But maybe there is no concrete answer to this question. But I started to wonder whether Santa Claus is immortal, or it is the title succeeded by others. If Santa Claus is immortal, why he is in elderly? If I was immortal, I want to keep my body and spirit of my 20s. So maybe he became immortal after he entered his elderly? But from the perspective as Buddhist, everything is impermanent, right? So Santa Claus cannot be immortal, but could be the title succeeded by the elves. That's my own understanding. But, you know, just like the name of Kabuki actors, they succeed the names. You know, the person is different, but they succeed the names. Like, there's a name called Ichikawa Danjuro. This name has kept for over 400 years. And there is still a Kabuki actor named Ichikawa Danjuro. Actually, Ichikawa Danjuro passed away, and Ichikawa Ebizo, who is going to be Ichikawa Danjuro, actually, he was going to receive Ichikawa Danjuro this year, but because of pandemic, he is not going to receive the title or the name Ichikawa Danjuro this year, but I believe he's receiving the name soon. So, you know, just like names of Kabuki, it's amazing how Santa Claus are keeping this tradition of giving alive for the centuries. And because of this tradition, we are able to see the happy faces of children. So I appreciate this opportunity to see the happy faces of children. My children are counting how many days left until Christmas. So, you know, that's the day they can receive the gift. So they are really looking forward to it. So, you know, as I talked a few weeks ago, it is same for us too. Each of us are successors of the Nembutsu teaching. I don't know how many generations, but we succeeded the teaching wish of Buddhas from ancestors, from the distant past, from the Buddhas, from Shinran Shonin and Seven Pure Masters, you know. If I am the successor of some traditions, I don't want to mislead people by conveying the wrong teaching. So that is why learning the teaching is important and listening to the Dharma is important. And we are receiving wonderful gift from the Buddha. Of course, Nembutsu teaching is one of the greatest gift we received from Buddhas. But also, we were able to meet each other in this life because of this teaching of Nembutsu, because of this Oregon Buddhist temple. And this teaching of Nembutsu gave us the Dharma family. And I am really glad that I was able to gather here with all my Dharma family in this holiday seasons. So I hope everybody keep this tradition, this teaching of Nembutsu, this Oregon Buddhist temple alive, and hand this teaching down to the next generations. So I wish you the happy holidays, and I am looking forward to meeting you soon again. So in closing, I would like to share the words of our eighth head priest, Renyo Shonin. So please join me in Gassho. Please put your palms together. The late master said, I, Shinran, do not have even a single disciple. The reason for this is that when I expound the Tathagata's Dharma to sentient beings in the 10 directions, I am only speaking as the Tathagata's representative. I do not propagate any new Dharma at all. I entrust myself, to the Tathagata's Dharma and simply teach that to others. Besides that, what do I teach that I would speak of having disciples? Thus, we have one another's companions and fellow practitioners. Because of this, the master spoke respectfully of companions and fellow practitioners. Namo Amida Butsu, Namo Amida Butsu, Namo Amida Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda. So this will conclude today's morning service. And after the service, we are going to have a Dharma exchange starting from 11. So if you have the link, please go to the Dharma exchange. Today's discussion is led by Dr. Al Ono. I believe he's going to talk about the holiday, if my memory is correct. But I hope you will have a great day today. And I'm sure I don't see you until next Sunday. So I hope you will have a great holiday with your friends, your families, even though it's online. So I hope you will have a great holidays and hope to see you next week. So thank you for attending.